Hello everyone, I'm Bang Weihe from Shandong University. Today I'm going to talk about my conference paper, Denoising CNN-based Channel Estimation for Vehicular OTFS Communication System. Next, I will describe the following six aspects: Introduction, OTFS System Model, OMP Channel Estimation, DCN-based Channel Estimation, Simulation Results, and Conclusion. First of all, let me briefly introduce the work of my paper. So a signal time frequency space technique can convert the double dispersive channel in the time frequency domain into a time environment channel in the delay Doppler domain. So a series of two-dimensional transformations. So we can call the delay Doppler domain as DD domain. As a key part in OTFS system, convolutional parallel-based channel estimation scheme has obvious drawbacks such as low accuracy and poor robustness to mobility. In this paper, we propose a denoising convolutional neural network based channel estimation scheme in OTFS system by introducing hybrid dilated convolutional HDC and residual passes into convolutional neural network. Then let me introduce the OTFS system model. As we can see in figure 1, the data symbol here must first be modulated by QAM. A QAM symbol frame of length m plus n is arranged into a two-dimensionally complex data set with size of m plus multiple n, where m and n are the number of delay and Doppler respectively. The OTFS frame signal SDD KL in the DD domain can be converted into a time frequency domain signal XTFNM by inversing finite Fourier transform, which can be expressed as equation 1. Then we use Heisenberg transform for XTFNM. The time domain signal ST is obtained as equation 2, so we can get ST. Subsequently, ST passes through the double selective feeding channel, and the time domain signal RT obtained as the receiver can be expressed as equation 3. So, the above is the basic process operation of OTFS transmitter. In equation 3, VNT donates the time domain additive Gaussian white noise. H tau mu is the channel impulse response with tau and mu being the DD domain path delay and Doppler frequency shift respectively, as shown as equation 4, where P is the multipath number, HP tau mu, tau P, and mu P represent the channel coefficient delay and Doppler expansion on the P's path. As a receiver, RT undergoes a received pulse matching and the Wigner transform as equation 5. So we can combine the equation 3, this one, and the equation 5, this one. The two-dimensional TF domain signal YTFNM can be obtained as equation 6. Finally, we can use the SFFT to YTFNM to obtain the two-dimensional DD domain receive signal YDDKL, which can be interpreted as equation 7. According to equation 4, HP tau mu is the DD channel coefficient corresponding to the P's path. The input-output relationship equation 7 of the OTFS communication system can be rewritten as equation 8. So we can rewrite this one to this one. And we give the vector form as equation 9. Next, we will introduce the OMP channel estimation algorithm. The key of the pilot-based channel estimation for OTFS communication system is the placement design of pilot symbol and data symbols. Since the DD domain channel can obtain the 4TF diversity gain, we can use the traditional pilot scheme to obtain the 4 channel response. The DD domain signal after inserting the pilot symbol can be rewritten as formula 10. So this one is the traditional scheme. So we can see this is a pilot symbol we insert, and this one is the protection intervals, and this is the data symbols. So ONP algorithm for channel estimation in vehicular OTFS communication system is illustrated in algorithm 1, where the receive signal vector Y and the pilot matrix X are set as the input. Besides, the multiple number P is the input too. As we can see in the TIS iteration, this one, in the TIS iteration, the residual RT minus 1, this one, RT minus 1 of the previous iteration is projected onto each column of X. The index ST, so this is the index ST of the column with the largest absolute product value is selected and added to the current spot ST. So we add this one to this one. And the pilot matrix X is the update. Next move is update our X. Then the least square method is employed to obtain the TIS estimator vector HT. So you can get the vector HT. And the residual RT is updated. Finally, set the iteration number as T equal T plus 1. This one. Once T is greater than P, it is satisfied. And the iteration is stopped. And the newly obtained HT. So we get this HT is the final output of OMP. Otherwise, the above OMP algorithm operates continuous. Next, let's introduce our DCN channel estimation. In this section, we formulated the channel estimation in OTFS communication system as a residual noise cancellation problem and propose a DCN method to enhance the extraction of the noise features by introducing hybrid dilated convolution into CNN and achieve the noise cancellation through residual passes. Therefore, the DCN method can improve the channel estimation accuracy, especially under low SNR. In the following, the DCN method is introduced in detail. First is CNN. Our module design is based on CNN. Here is a brief introduction to the basic structure of CNN. CNN can extract features from input data by convolutional operations and reduce model parameters by weight sharing, which has low computational complexity. So this is the key part. Low complexity. And the basic CNN consists of an input layer, convolutional layer, activation function, and the output layer, as shown in figures 3. This is the basic structure of CNN. Next, we introduce HDC. CNN has a problem of decreasing solutions and losing local information. Thus, HDC can be introduced into convolutional layer to solve the above problem by expanding the receptive field. Take figure 4 as an example. When the deletion rates of two superimposed convolutional layers are set to be 1 and 2, this is the deletion rate equal 1, this is equal 2. The perceptual field can be expanded, as we can see. The perceptual field is obviously expanded. Finally, let's talk about the DCN our design. So we designed the DCN-based channel estimation scheme in this subsection, which consists of an input layer, two noise cancellation modules. This is the two noise cancellation modules, and the output layer as shown in figure 5. First, the pre-estimation channel matrix HOMP by the operation estimator is taken as the input of the DCN, and the real matrix H is used as a label. So the first noise cancellation model, the DCAN distinguishes the difference between HOMP and H to achieve the extraction of the noise matrix, HN. So we extract HN and get the H out. Then the channel matrix H out from the output layer of the first noise cancellation model is obtained by the subtracting HN from HOMP through the residual pass. Finally, H out is used as the input of the second noise cancellation model, and the actual channel matrix H is also set as the label. So the above operation is repeated to obtain the final channel estimation matrix. So we repeat the process of this one and get the final estimating vector, HDCN. So above channel estimation can eliminate the noise interference and achieve better accuracy. In this section, we provide the simulation results of DCAN-based channel estimation scheme for vehicular OTFS communication system. The vehicle is regarded as a single antenna transmitter, and the base station is set as the receiver with four received antennas. We adopt 3GPP standardized urban scenario channel modeling. So the table one is a detailed simulation parameter. We can see we use number of subcarriers and OTFS symbols, vehicle speed, channel model, and all of this. The NMSE performance of the proposed DCAN method, OMP algorithm, and the pilot based scheme is shown in figure 6. It's found that DCAN method performs much better than OMP algorithm and the pilot-based scheme because the DCAN method is a nonlinear estimator that can learn the noise features and eliminate the noise. In addition, the DCAN method, we can see the DCAN method is outperforms the other two convolutional schemes, especially in the case of low SNR. So the DCAN method is much better. This is because the DCAN method can realize better noise feature extractions and achieve the noise cancellation well when the noise interference is strong. In the context of mobile vehicular communication, the channel parameters vary quickly with the increase of the vehicle speed. According to the DCAN method, it has good robustness to the variation of channel parameters. Figure 7 shows the effect of vehicle speed on the NMSE performance at SNR equal 5 dB, 10 dB, and 15 dB. It is seen that the NMSE performance gradually decreased when the SNR increased at the same speed. When the SNR is fixed, the vehicle speed increased from 14 to 120. But the NMSE performance is almost unchanged. This is because the DCAN method has a strong adaptability to the variable channel parameters. Therefore, the DCAN method proposed in this paper has good robustness under different vehicle speeds, which can realize the channel estimation with high accuracy even when the vehicle speed is changed and enhance the reliability of communication in the vehicular communication scenarios. In the OTFS communication system, the time delay affects the DD domain channel. Therefore, we consider the signal arrival time, gamma, from user to base station in vehicular communication scenarios. In this simulation, we set the vehicle speed to 80. Figure 8 shows the effect of gamma on the NMSE performance at different SNR. It is found that the NMSE performance gradually improves when gamma increases at the same SNR. Since the higher delay can improve the delay resolution in the DD domain, thus making channel state better. So the NMSE performance of the DCNN method doesn't vary significantly when gamma change from 0.25 seconds to 1 second, which proves the DCNN method has good robustness under different gamma and has better channel estimation stability in different vehicular communication scenarios. And finally, it's our conclusion. In this paper, a DCNN-based channel estimation scheme for vehicular OTFS communication system is proposed. OMP algorithm is first employed for the bus pre-estimation. In addition, HDC and residual pass are combined into CNN to address the noise features and eliminate the noise influence, which further improves the accuracy of estimation. Simulation results show that the proposed DCNN method can achieve better performance under low SNR compared with the other convolutional channel estimation schemes and show good robustness to Doppler estimation under different vehicle speeds. And this is my job and my work. Thank you very much.